This is the day that the Lord hath made, that the Lord hath made. I will rejoice, I will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. Well, this is the day that the Lord hath made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Well, now this is the day. This is the day that the Lord hath made. Now Jesus is the way. Jesus is the way that the Lord hath made. That the Lord hath made. I will rejoice. I will rejoice and be glad in it. And be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord hath made. Jesus is the way that the Lord hath made. Now this is the day. This is the day that the Lord hath made. Well, praise God, this is the day the Lord hath made. Friday morning, 10 o'clock in the morning. Exciting time here in Tampa, Florida. We're starting to get a little bit of rain. We hadn't had rain for forever. We've been in an all-time drought. But praise God. God has answered our prayer, and He's bringing a refreshing into Tampa, Florida. I'm Pastor George Walters, Faith Outreach Center here in Tampa, Florida, in town and country area. But what a joy it is to be with you this morning. I hope you're having a great day. I hope you realize that this is a day that God made just for you. He brought the sea. He made the sunrise just for you this morning. He's bringing the rain just for you this morning, that we can enjoy the very goodness and the handiwork and the mighty, mighty, incredible touch that He puts on our lives. Praise God. I want to talk to you for a few moments out of Psalms 18. Psalms 18. And it's an incredible psalm because David wrote this psalm, and he wrote it. In fact, many of the psalms that you look in Scripture, many of the psalms were written out of certain experiences. I'll give you an example. Psalms 27, where it says, "The Lord is my light, my salvation. The Lord is the strength of my life. Whom shall I fear? Even though the wicked one might come beat up my flesh, he'll stumble and fall. Though a host may encamp against me." All that took place when David was in Ziklag. He had a camp set up there. He was out, had all his men out in the battle, came back, and his camp was burnt to the ground. The women and children were all taken captive. Everything they had was gone, nothing but a burned ruin. And David's men started blaming David. He didn't set up a garrison. He didn't protect them enough. They even threatened to kill him. And the Bible says that David strengthened himself in the Lord. Sometimes you can't expect a draw from other people. Sometimes they don't understand what you're going through. And you got to strengthen yourself in the Lord. In this Psalms 18, it's interesting that David was a young man, good-looking, strong, a warrior. And he went out to battle, and Saul went out to battle. They came back one day from the battlefield. And all the women were praising David and says, "Oh, David killed his 10,000 and Saul only killed his 1,000. And Saul got jealous about it. And he said, "Why are you making such a big deal about this young David? I'm the king here." And he got jealous. And from that point on, in fact, a couple times he tried to kill David with a javelin. And David had to flee for his life, go out and hide in the caves. And Saul was after him. There was one occasion that Saul was so close to him that he chased him and trying to take his life. And there was times that David was so close to Saul that he could have took his life. And yet, I believe that it was that experience, and there were so many enemies because Saul was king, was coming after David, that David wrote this psalm. And I'm going to share it with you. It's Psalms 18, verse 1. "I will love you, O Lord." Oh, listen, in the midst of the storms you're going through, maybe some of you are going through something right now. And maybe there's a physical issue that you've been praying about. Maybe there's something going on with your family or your children, even a marriage maybe. Let me say this to you. This is the time to say, "Lord, I love you, O Lord, and I trust you, and you're going to bring me through this thing." And Not only that, he said, I will love you, O Lord, my strength. He recognized his strength was in the Lord. God is our strength. And then he starts to expound on the mighty attributes of God. Sometimes when you're going through a tough time in your life, sometimes what you need to do is just start praising God for his goodness. Think back to all the times he brought you through something. Think back to where you was up against it. You didn't know which way to go. And you was up against a wall. You couldn't go around it. You couldn't go under it. You couldn't go on top of it. And you cried out to the Lord and said, Lord, I'm not strong enough for this, but you're my strength. And then it says, the Lord my rock and my fortress and my deliverer. Oh, praise God. Listen, whenever you don't have the answer, God is the answer. When you're not sure how you're going to make it through any given situation, that's when you recognize he's the rock. What is the rock? A rock is something that's solid that you can stand on. When the winds blow and the storms come, it won't wash out. In fact, there's a parable that Jesus spoke of in the Gospels and said that there was two men. One built his house upon the rock, and the storms came and the winds blew and the rains descended, and the house stood because it was upon the solid rock. There was another man who built his house upon the sand. That means he didn't have any foundation. That means he didn't have anything solid that he built his life on. And when the winds came, the same elements that was on the other man's house came upon this, and the winds blew. The storms, the rains descended, and it said the house was washed away, and great was its destruction. And so that's when we need to know who the Lord is. He's our rock, and he's my fortress. He's my deliverer, and he's the one that will see us through.
Then David said,
in the midst of this time when Saul was chasing him all over the country and threatening his life, and he always had to look around his shoulder to see if someone was out to get him, he said, my God, my strength, in whom I will trust. Listen, trust the Lord. Put your trust in him. I like what Solomon said in Proverbs. Trust the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding, and he'll direct your path. Sometimes we try to figure it out ourselves. How am I going to get out of this thing? How am I going to fix this situation? What am I going to do to make things work? And sometimes you don't have the answers because the problem is bigger than you are. And that's when you have to say, Lord, you're my strength. It's you that I will trust. And then he said, oh, Lord, you're my shield, and you're the horn of my salvation. You're my stronghold, and I will call upon the Lord. Sometimes you don't have the answer. Sometimes you don't know what to do. You're at a crossroads in your life. I know people right now that are at a crossroads in their life. They're at a decision point. They're not sure whether to go to the left or the right. They're not sure whether to go straight down the road. They're the place in their life where they're not sure what their future holds. That's when you have to say, Lord, you're my shield. You're the horn of my salvation. You're the stronghold, and I will call upon you, and you'll give me the right direction how to go. And then it says, I will call upon the Lord who is worthy to be praised. When you don't know what to do, start praising the Lord. When you don't know what to do, start talking to God and telling him how much you love him and how much you trust in him and how he's the stronghold in your life and he's your strength. And you'll find out that when you start to praise him, it says, so shall I be saved from my enemies. When you start to praise the Lord and exalt him, the enemies have to flee. The problems have to change. The storms have to cease because God starts to reach down in your behalf and do great things in your life. Well, you know, it's been great. I hope you got a few things out of this. That was Psalms 18. Psalms 18, verses 1, 2, and 3. Go back and read it to yourself and let it be a strength to you. And let God touch you in a mighty way today. Remember, this is the day the Lord made. And he made it just for you today.
Let me pray. Father, I thank
you for those that are listening. I ask that you bless them right now. Bless those, God, that are drawing strength from you. Especially those, God, that are at a crossroads in their life or maybe going through a storm right now. I pray that you bring them through and you'll show them their future that you're in it.
We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you.